The name Perkins carved in stone. Below a Gothic tower, a boy navigates with a cane. A title, Visual Fields with Louisa Mayer.
We do differentiate between visual acuity and visual field. Visual acuity being the centermost part of vision where we focus on things, we fixate, we see details. Everything else is the visual field, even though it's really one continuous surface. There really is no separation in our vision or in our minds between visual acuity and visual field. Some important things about the visual field is, first of all, as I showed you, if you do this, you hold your finger when you can't see it, you bring it forward, and you see it, you're aware of it out in your field and out here. That's the fullest extent of your field. And it's actually a little more than 180. It's actually a little more than 90 degrees from fixation, which is where we really like to count in this field.
We see a pencil sketch of an adult male face head-on with the left eye covered by the left hand. A shaded semicircular wedge shape depicting the horizontal range of the right visual field extends from the eye along a horizontal plane and is bisected by a line dividing the wedge into the nasal and temporal fields. The nasal field is described by an arc of 60 degrees. The temporal field, on the other side of the axis, is 100 degrees for a total range of 160 degrees in the right eye.
And then when you're thinking about the upper field, the farthest position up you see is about 60 to 70 degrees. And the farthest position you can see out, the farthest amount of degrees, is actually way down here, but I'll bring it up so my finger is seen. It's sort of 80 to 90 degrees, so it's very big.
A second sketch shows an adult male head in profile. A shaded semicircular wedge shape extends from the eye in a vertical plane and is bisected by a line representing the horizontal axis, dividing the wedge into upper and lower fields. The upper field limit is 60 degrees from the axis, the lower field 75 degrees, for a total range of 135 degrees.
Your vision off to the side is coarser or rougher, and you don't see colors as well. You don't see details really very well at all. You do see big, gross patterns. You see contrast differences. So, for example, I can see the wall contrast over there when I'm just looking at your face. And that's really important for understanding what peripheral vision is for and what it does.
A third sketch shows a male figure looking at a chart of concentric circles that intersect horizontal and vertical axes at 10-degree increments. It is a Goldman perimeter chart. A dotted line describes a rough oval shape and marks the plotted limits of the right visual field. The elongated and largest part of the field is to the right of the vertical axis.
So if we think about what the peripheral field does do for us, we can think about when we move around. When we move around through obstacles, go downstairs, reach for something, do any physical activity, sports, ride a bicycle, all those things of daily life that take physical movement, we're using peripheral vision. It's really important for that. It's not that we are not also using our detail vision, because we are, because we're scanning around. We see something to the side, we scan to it. That's being cued by peripheral vision to a target out to the side. So that's really important. There's another aspect of peripheral vision that's very important too, and it's for doing detail tasks. For example, for reading. When you're reading a page, you fixate on a word, and you're anticipating your reading off to the right, and that's in your peripheral vision. So you have to be aware of those word images. You may even see some of them as you're scanning to the right. You really need peripheral vision for fluent reading as well. And it's one of the problems with people who have a visual field loss, particularly on the right side. They don't scan very easily to the right. And so what they'll do is they'll jump their eye way off and then scan back and then jump way off, because they don't see just to the right of fixation. They don't see that word just to the right.
Fade to black.